Did you know that you can deploy Azure SQL anywhere with Azure Arc enabled data services? Learn more from Ben in this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Ben. Ben, thanks for joining us today again. Can you start by telling us a little bit about yourself?
Thank you for having me again. I wasn't sure if I was ever going to be invited again, but then again, I was kind of my best behavior last time. Yeah, MVP from Nuremberg, Germany, mostly in the data warehousing and BI field. And last time we spoke about big data clusters. And well, now I guess I'm here for something new.
Yeah, we're excited to be learning something new. You know, it's this ever-evolving thing, and I'm excited to learn what you have to share with us today about Azure Arc. So without too much preamble, I thought I'd just ask you, you know, can you tell our viewers and myself what is Azure Arc and how does it relate to, you know, things we know like Azure SQL and SQL Server?
So Azure Arc is this real cool thing. It kind of is bring your own data center, but still enjoy the luxury of Azure services in general, I should rather say. So Azure Arc is not just for the data world, but we're going to be focusing mainly on the data world. The idea of Azure Arc is you go to any cloud with any infrastructure and any Kubernetes. So this can be Azure Kubernetes service. You can run your own Kubernetes. I'm basically running my own Arc data center in my basement, which we're going to see in the demo later. You can run it in any of the other public or private clouds, so AWS, Google Cloud, you name them, which means wherever you go, it doesn't matter. It can be on-premise, it can be private, it can be public, it can be connected and disconnected. We're also going to see that in the other slide. And there's data services, there's Arc Kubernetes services, there's all kinds of Azure services that are moving to other clouds. Again, on-premise is kind of a cloud in that context. And the idea for the data world here is we get managed instances and PostgreSQL, PostgreSQL hyperscale into your own private estate, still having all the luxuries that you would get from the classic Azure SQL service. Well, classic, I mean, they're all brand new and still, you get them, you get to see them in the portal, you get to manage them still on-prem, you get managed backups, you get managed updates, all that. So, but all that without having to be locked into the Azure cloud, which is a big deal for many people that either run multi-cloud strategies or that just say, well, I cannot move away from on-prem with some of my data for performance. You may just be sitting on an oil rig and just not have the connectivity to everything to run into the Azure cloud nonstop. So what does that mean for the Azure Arc enabled data services? You start by just deploying your Kubernetes cluster. And I keep that rather general because, like I said, this can be kubeadm, AKS, EKS, all kinds of flavors. And on top of that, you deploy a so-called Azure Arc data controller. This is kind of like your main endpoint. And if we remember big data clusters, we had the big data cluster controller. So this is kind of the counterpart to that, to the Azure Arc world, if you want. So one single point of entry, and that's kind of the only thing that you really have to deploy. And this will kind of take care of everything else that's going on there. And this is happening, again, through the Azure Data CLI, through AZ Data, which we are also using for big data clusters. So Azure Arc, or Azure Arc-enabled data services, I should rather say, that is kind of the answer to that question, the end of that path where people are wondering, SQL and Linux, SQL and Kubernetes, I kind of see what it's doing, why. This is why, because now we get all this in those containers, in those orchestrated containers. Just like with big data clusters, again, we can either use AZ Data directly or we can use Azure Data Studio, a tool that more and more people are using for exactly those purposes, managing, deploying, and developing their data solutions. We got it connected to the Azure portal. And again, same through that same logic, we will also be deploying our data instances. Like, again, like I said, Azure SQL Managed Instance or Azure Database for PostgreSQL. Those are the two offerings we would get in Arc-enabled data services right now. By the way, Arc-enabled data services are in public preview, so we still get like monthly releases with more and more interesting features coming. You can, since we're in Azure Data Studio, you can even automate all that through Git merges if you want. So you can have automated build and deployment pipelines for your data estate. And you get the same Kibana and Grafana interfaces that you already know from SQL and Kubernetes and big data clusters. And we got the link back to the portal. And like I said, depending on where you are, you may have a direct connection to the internet, to the Azure cloud or not. And that's why there's basically two ways of getting those metrics and log files into the portal. You can do the direct mode, which means your data controller will constantly upload your consumption data and log files for analysis to the Azure portal. Or you can use the indirect mode. And indirect mode basically means that you're running a script every hour, every minute, every week, every month that will just push that data to the portal so your resources will show up there and are available for analysis. So let's take a quick look at that in Azure Data Studio. And this is just PowerShell, what I'm doing here, but I decided to still run it in an ADS notebook, so we've got it all in one place. And I already got my controller here in my basement deployed. So what I can do is I can see, well, I got already three managed instances and one PostgreSQL instance deployed there. And I can manage all that right here in Azure Data Studio. But I can also just run a PowerShell command where I can say, show me all those instances. So again, I can do that through code or through the user interface, depending on what I prefer. And I will see my three managed instances showing up, including their external endpoints. Well, external from the Kubernetes perspective, those are private IP addresses because I'm running that in my own private basement data center. And if I want to create a new managed instance, all I would need to do is run this command here, azdata-arc-sql-mi-create. So if I would do this and just do go titans
one.
I think Bob Ward, he's a big fan of the Titans, so I'm doing this especially for him.
Yeah, huge fan.
Unless I'm mixed. Well, him and Buck, of course, because Buck is like the biggest sports fan that is out there. So again, if I would be preferring something from with a graphical interface, I could have gone here and say new instance, basically doing the same thing. So this would, exactly the user agreement, I could say, well, this would be my Go Titans 2, and I could either just script it to a notebook that I could run later or deploy it right from here. We're sticking to just running it right here in PowerShell. And what this will do is in my Kubernetes cluster, it will create another pod, Go Titans 01/0. That is, by the way, super interesting. In Azure Arc, this will also be the platform which allows me to run, which is why it's saying -0. There could be a -1, -2 if I had multiple instances. This would be the way to bring SQL Server availability groups into Kubernetes, which is currently not supported by the regular SQL Server, quote unquote. So this is running, this is creating my instance. And if I would go back here and refresh this, we would also see this is being created. So we see this instance as creating. And once you've got your first instance created, all the consecutive ones usually take about a minute to a minute and a half. So there we go. Go Titans 01 is ready. And if I do a refresh here, I would see the instance just as well. If I do the azdata arc SQL MI list here, it would show up the instance, including its endpoint and including its IP address and port, so I could connect to it. Pretty cool.
Nice. Pretty cool. It's a good bit faster than installing SQL Server.
Slightly. Well, for those trying this at home, the first time will take a little bit longer because it actually needs to download SQL. And that's, again, the beauty of Kubernetes. Once it's got all these images downloaded to its local library, if you want so, this, I mean, 90 seconds for a SQL Server, that's and not just a regular SQL Server, because if we just go here and do a select add version on one of my managed instances, what you will see is this is not just SQL Server or SQL Server on Linux. But what I have here running on my local premises, I got my Microsoft Azure SQL Database Managed Instance Azure Arc. So this is a managed instance. This would get automated updates. This would get automated backups, all that, if configured for that specific instance. I could get all the local information on that, like in my Grafana dashboard. If I go here, where of course I did not deploy a certificate, this would get me my SQL Server metrics. I could go to all the different instances that I got deployed here, how many transactions, how many batch requests I could see, what's actually happening on my host. But I can also get that back to the Azure portal. And this is where it gets super cool, if you ask me, because that means in the end, no matter where my databases are running, no matter where my instances are running, I get them all in one single place. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm exporting the log files here. And this is something that you should schedule in the real world. So have that run every 2 minutes, every 2 hours, unless you're in direct mode where, like I said, this would be happening automatically. So what this will just do is it will collect all the log files and metrics from all these instances. And you can see it already picked up my Go Titan. So it's not like I have to configure anything. It will just do it for every single instance that I've deployed. And then the next step, I will just upload those to the portal, again, using AZ data. So what this will do is we'll take the files that I just created, the two JSON files, push them into my log analytics workspace in Azure. And if I go into my Azure portal and do a refresh here, you will see there's my local MI01, where I could now see the metrics for that specific instance right here in the Azure portal. So what happened to my CPU on that on-premise SQL instance? I see it in the portal. If I go to the overview, I would also see, well, it's running in Ben's basement. This is my endpoint. So this is where it's all coming together. And this is the beauty of Azure Arc enabled data services, or Azure Arc in general.
That's pretty cool, because that kind of means like wherever your SQL is running, if you have it connected to the Azure portal, you're going to be able to kind of manage and monitor them all from one place. Am I understanding that correctly?
Correct. Without the worry of running your own updates and all that. So all the beauty that you get from managed services on your own infrastructure or somebody else's infrastructure. It's like I said, it's bring your own data center if you want so.
And love it.
I think that is amazing, because it really gives you that flexibility no matter where that restriction is coming from.
Awesome, cool. Well, thanks, Ben. This has been really interesting. And you know, for our viewers, you've actually been pretty busy with Azure Arc enabled data services. I think you might have something you might want to announce or share with our viewers.
Indeed, my very good friend Anthony Innocentino and myself, we wrote a quick book on Azure Arc enabled data services, because I'm kind of known for writing book on technology where you will know for sure that the technology will change 5 times until the final product comes out. So this is based on the current public preview, but it was big fun writing that. Travis, the PM for Arc enabled data service, actually was nice enough to write us a great foreword for that book. And yeah, if you want to find out more about Azure Arc enabled data services, how to deploy them, also more about the technical background, make sure to check out our book. I hope it's worth it. And yeah, let us know what you think.
Awesome. Thanks, Ben. And you know, I think for our viewers, it's a great call to action. You want to learn more about Azure Arc enabled data services, then definitely check out Ben and Anthony's book. We'll put some links in the description. Ben, again, thanks so much for joining me today. And to our viewers, thanks for tuning in. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.